Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. So this video is going to present the second part of your half-wave rectifier, and we are going to cover the parameter of peak inverse voltage and the duty cycle for half-wave rectifier. Alright, the first one is the peak inverse voltage. So peak inverse voltage is also known as maximum reverse bias voltage. So basically, it is a parameter that is provided by the manufacturer of the diode. So it will tell you how much voltage that the diode can withstand before you damage the diode, right? So sometimes people can make mistake by providing a negative voltage to make it reverse bias, kan? So for example, in this square here, so this is the silicon diode. Alright, and you can see here it says that the peak reverse voltage is 100 volt, and at the same time the data sheet also provided this RMS reverse voltage. So what is the relationship between peak and RMS? So this is the relationship. Okay, so basically the RMS value is equivalent to the peak value divided by square root of 2. So this is a formula that you need to memorize, because sometimes, for example, in the transformer, okay, we will give you the value of the RMS and you have to convert to peak value, because the question asks for the peak value of the current, peak value of the voltage. So you need to begin with the peak value of your source voltage so that you will get peak values in your subsequent answers. Or you can also start with RMS and then get your answers in RMS, but you still need to convert to peak because the question asks for peak value. So might as well you change it initially. Okay? Okay, so now you know the definition of PIV. So let's see the PIV value for a diode that is placed in a half-wave circuit. So this is your half-wave circuit. Okay, so you can see here, this is during negative cycle, alright? So the polarity of your secondary voltage, the positive terminal is at the bottom, and this is the negative terminal, and the current will want to go in this direction, okay? However, the current cannot go in this direction because it will hit the wall, okay? You can see here, this is the wall of your diode. So basically, actually, your current cannot flow, which means that actually your diode is reverse bias. So that's what I've labeled here. Your diode is reverse bias. The positive terminal has been connected to the N-type of your diode, and the negative terminal is connected to your P-type. Alright, so I want to know how much is this, and then I will compare with the data sheet. Alright, so if I do my KVL here, okay, this is the calculation to calculate the maximum reverse bias voltage. So if I do my KVL here, so I have minus VR plus Vout plus VS. So initially, this is the equation of the KVL, okay? Minus VR plus Vout plus VS. However, because Vout is measured across R and there is no current flow, your Vout is zero. And that's how I get the equation minus VR plus 0 plus VS. Because I want to know my maximum value, obviously it has to be the peak value. Peak value of your sine wave, which is at the 90 degrees. So that is the maximum value that it can withstand. So the PIV for your diode in a half wave rectifier is equivalent to VS peak. Therefore, in the previous example, if you look at the video in part 1, the PIV for the diode is 10 volt. Okay, so that's how you calculate the PIV for your diode. You need to find out at what conditions that the diode becomes reverse bias, and then calculate the value of VR. So that was the PIV for your half-wave rectifier. So now let's look at the duty cycle for your half-wave. So the definition of duty cycle is the fraction of the wave cycle over which the diode is conducting. So what it means is that, so you know that the sine wave has this cycle, okay? So basically, out of this whole cycle, how much fraction of this cycle that the diode is conducting. So I want to know the percentage. Okay. So again, we look back at the previous example in video part 1. We know that theta 1 is the point where your diode starts to conduct. So I want to know what is the value of theta 1. Okay. So theta 1 can be calculated by arc sine. You can see here inverse sine, because we know the point where it start to turn on, which is this value V gamma, kan? Alright, the equation of your secondary voltage ni is 10 sine theta. Okay, so at theta 1, okay, you can calculate the arc sine using this. So 10 sine theta 1 equivalent to 0.6. So you use inverse sine and you get the first angle. So this is the angle where your secondary voltage reach V gamma, right? However, you know that it will reach V gamma again at theta 2, which means that theta 2 can be calculated using 180 degrees minus theta 1. So you get the second angle, 176.56 degrees, which is right before the 180 degrees, kan? So now, if you want to find the duty cycle, you need to use this formula. Okay, so theta 2 minus theta 1, so this is a fraction where your diode turns on, over 2 pi. Okay, so it has to be 2 pi or 360 degrees. Okay, because this is the whole cycle. 180 degrees is here, so this is the 360, and then it goes to the second cycle. So this is the percentage, 48%. The answer for duty cycle is always in percentage. So you can see here, this is very close to 50%. So for half-wave rectifier, our target is to reach as close to 50% as possible. So that is the ideal case. So I hope you can understand how to calculate duty cycle. And we're going to look at the example where you will calculate PIV and duty cycle for half-wave. Okay? So in this example, you can see this is your half-wave. Okay? And the question would like to calculate the peak output voltage, the peak diode current, and the duty cycle. Okay, so the important thing that I want you to take note is the question gives the primary voltage as RMS. Okay, don't worry about the 60 Hz because we're not going to use it in this calculation. And you are given the N1 over N2 ratio. So you are going to calculate VS, but please convert your primary voltage into peak value first before you divide to calculate secondary voltage. This is because the questions are asking for peak values, the output voltage and the diode current. So in order to solve this, we're going to go to the whiteboard. You have the answer here. So later, based on my calculation, you can compare with these answers. Okay?
A few moments later.
So in that example, you are given the V primary and V secondary with a 10 to 1 ratio. And this is connected to your half wave rectifier. Okay. The resistor is given as 2 kilo ohm. So your VP is given as 120 volt RMS. So you need to convert to peak value. Alright? We already established that VRMS is equivalent to V peak over square root 2. So V peak equivalent to 120 multiplied with square root 2. And you will get 169.7 volt. Okay, so this is a peak value for your primary voltage. Okay, so in order to get your VS, you're going to use the other formula, which is VP over VS equivalent to N1 over N2. So you're going to use this formula in order to find what is VS. Okay, so I'm going to wipe this off and we're going to calculate VS now. Alright, okay. In order to find VS, we use this formula. So 169.7, okay, over VS equivalent to 10 to 1. Okay, so this is the ratio given in the question.
So Vs will be equivalent to 16.97 volt. So this is peak value already. So it's easier for you to calculate the peak value for the rest of the parameters. Right. So you have established what is the peak value for your secondary voltage, which is this point. So you can calculate the other parameters. So now you already know that Vs equivalent to 16.97 volt. So the first question asks for the peak voltage of your V out. So this is your Vd and this is your V out. So this is your Vs and the peak value is 16.97, right? So if I do my KVL here, we know that V out minus Vs plus Vd equivalent to 0. Okay, so I want to know what is V out equivalent to Vs minus Vd. So if I want to know V out peak, might as well I use Vs peak straight away, right? So in the question, what is my Vd? Vd is model 2 because you are only given V gamma equivalent to 0.7 volt, right? So V out peak equivalent to 16.97 minus 0.7, which is your V gamma, equivalent to 16.27 volt. So that is the answer for your V out peak. So again, I'm going to wipe this off. So we have established that for part 1, V out peak is 16.27 volt. Okay, so for part 2, the question asks for the peak diode current. So I have mentioned in the introduction video, okay, that in the half-wave circuit, you will have the same current. So this is ID. So this will also be ID. Alright. And you have already know what is the voltage across your resistor. And you know the resistor is 2 kilo ohm, which means that you can use Ohm's law. So use Ohm's law to calculate what is your ID peak. Okay, so if I go here, so V out equivalent to ID times 2 kilo ohm, so ID peak as well, okay, so you can calculate V out using your V out peak over 2, and you will get 16.27 over 2K, you will have 8.135 milliampere. Okay, so you have done part 1 and part 2. So normally the question will be related to each other. You already got V out peak, and if you know that the current will be the same, then you just use Ohm's law to calculate your ID peak. Okay, so now let's have a look for part 3, which is your duty cycle. Okay, so to begin calculating your duty cycle, so we go back to the beginning, which is the sine wave of your Vs. So this is Vs, and remember the peak value is 16.97. We know that it will start at a point known as theta 1, where it will reach V gamma. And V gamma in this question is 0.7 volt. What is the equation of your secondary voltage? You know the peak value, so it will be 16.97 sine theta. So this is your Vs equation. So now let's find your theta 1. Okay, so we know that at theta 1, 16.97 sine theta 1, okay, equivalent to what? V gamma. It will be equivalent to V gamma when the angle reaches theta 1. So this is 0.7 volt. Okay, so using arc sine, theta 1 is equivalent to sine minus 1. 0.7, 16.97, and you will find the angle. The answer is 2.36 degrees. Okay, as I mentioned in the video just now, there will be another angle called theta 2, where this point will also be V gamma. You can find theta 2 by using this equation, 180 minus 2.36 degree, and you will get 177.64 degrees. So you know these two angles. So now let us find the duty cycle, right? So duty cycle is theta 2 minus theta 1 over 360 degrees multiplied by 100%. And you will get the answer 48.68%, which is relatively close to 50%. Okay, so I hope you can understand now on how to calculate the duty cycle. So what if the question asks for the PIV for the half-wave rectifier? So because the half-wave rectifier is a standard rectifier circuit, just like this, okay? So this is your VD, and the current will flow during the positive cycle. So we know that during negative cycle, okay, the polarity of your VS will be inverted because of the negative cycle, and there is no current flow through your diode because it's reverse bias, and therefore V out is equivalent to 0 volt. So the diode will be reverse bias. So I want you to look at how I label the reverse bias voltage. Okay, so this is VD and this is VR. Okay, so if I do my KVL, I will have minus VR plus 0 plus VS equivalent to 0, VR equivalent to VS. And for peak inverse voltage or the maximum reverse bias voltage, I will find what is VS peak. And we already calculated that when we calculate the RMS and peak and so on, right? So VR equivalent to VS peak, 16.97 volt. So that's the answer if the question asks about the PIV for this diode in this example. Okay, thank you very much.
So in the next video, I will be presenting the full wave rectifier circuit, and there are two types, the center tap rectifier and the bridge rectifier. So I'll see you then. Assalamualaikum and take care. Bye.